anybody way won't fight you. Better come, they already know. I'll be right beside you, like the wall of Jericho. They don't know, they don't know, they don't know what's going on. Monagiso, Monagiso, my baby boy. I'll be a soldier for you. I'm getting better in Kung Fu. You should know I got you, and you don't need to got me too. I'll be right beside you in anything that you do. If you ever need saving, I will be running to you. Running, running, running to you. I've been running to you, running, running, running to you. Anywhere that you go to,
I know. I love it.
I'm excited. I'm ready. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
What?
Today we're here to celebrate the marriage of Matthew and Abinahi.
Abiyua.
Abiyua. Thank you. I was worried I was going to mess up Matthew. What can I say? But before we start, I did want to tell you the best marriage advice I ever received. I was at a party celebrating the 70th anniversary of a couple. They had been married for 70 years. And the man walked up to me and said, "Do you want to know the secret to being married for 70 years?" And I said, "Of course." And he said, "Don't die." When I think about marriage, and I think about most everything, I always return to the book of Matthew, to the Sermon on the Mount. It happens to be my favorite passage of the Bible. The Sermon on the Mount begins with a series of blessings. It's a series of things that help you through life. And these are referred to as the Beatitudes. And they're a strange list, but I think they apply to life, and I think they apply to marriage. And they're strange because the very first one is, "Blessed are the poor in spirit." And you think, what does that have to do with anything? Well, it's the acknowledgement that we can't do it on our own. We in ourselves can't do it. You have to have each other to make the marriage work. You have to have family, you have to have friends. But above all else, you have to have God. Without God, it's not going to work. So we talk about blessed are the poor in spirit. And the second characteristic is even stranger. It talks about mourning, crying. And you think, what does that have to do with life and marriage? But the blessing that goes with it is that even though we mourn, there's going to be sad times. There's going to be good times. But the blessing that comes with it is that with the mourning, God will provide comfort. And hopefully, you will provide comfort, and you will provide comfort. Rest assured, God has promised, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." The next characteristic that God gives us is, "Blessed are the meek." And we hate the word meek because it sounds too much like the word weak. A better translation is gentleness. When you are having difficulty, when you are just living life, be gentle to each other. You know, there'll come a time where you'll want to not be gentle. You'll want to be harsh. And God says, "Blessed are those who are gentle. Blessed are those who are meek." The next one is, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness." You're going to pursue a lot of things in your life. You're going to pursue marriage, family. You're going to pursue a lot of things. But above and beyond all of that, so your marriage and your life will work, pursue righteousness. Pursue what God would have you to do. And we're promised that if we pursue it, God will provide it to us. Blessed are the merciful. This one's a tough one because it says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. There will be a time when you will need to receive mercy. There'll be a time when you'll need to give mercy. And the Bible kind of makes it clear. I don't like this. But if we're not going to give mercy, we may not receive mercy. And a marriage needs mercy. A marriage needs the acknowledgement that, yes, I'm still on your side. I'm still with you. After that comes, blessed are the pure in heart. Pure in heart means you don't have mixed motives. Your love should be pure. It's not I love you and something else. It's just I love you. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers. I know this for a fact. When you start getting children in the house, you need a few peacemakers. But you need it even before then. You need it with family. You need it with friends. You need it with each other. Because once again, like mercy that came before this, there'll be a time when you won't want to make peace. You want to stir up the pot a little bit. You didn't get your way. You didn't get your way. Poke, poke, poke. But we're not to be that way. Blessed are the peacemakers. Be the one that pursues peace. Now, don't wait for her. Don't wait for him. Be the one that pursues peace. And finally, the last characteristic is even more strange. Blessed are you when you have trouble. Why would we be blessed when we have trouble? Because once again, God has promised us that in the middle of our trouble, He will provide, He will bless, He will give what we need. So, as we start our married life, I encourage you, blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are the merciful. Blessed are the gentle. Because God has told us this is what we need for our everyday life. And this is what we need to make our marriage work. We have vows. Not yet. We have vows first. We'll start with Matthew and Abba Yahweh.
Abby's fine. Abby's fine.
Abby's fine?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. I've tried.
You did.
All day. Matt, please repeat after me. I, Matt, take thee, Abby.
I, Matt, take thee, Abby.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and worse.
For better and worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
Abby, repeat after me. I, Abby, take thee, Matt.
I, Abby, take thee, Matt.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Until death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
The bride and the groom have written some personal vows. If y'all would bring them up, please.
Abby, I did not know what true love was until I met you. When our own journeys and explorations through life intersected, I knew deep down in my soul that you were the one for me. You inspire me and challenge me to be a better person. Your wit and laughter give me joy, even from your alter egos, Lucy and Vanessa. I'm so thankful God blessed my life with yours, and I'm so happy that we get to spend the rest of our waking moments together. I promise to be a loving and faithful husband, to be your best friend, and to endure life's peaks and valleys with you. I promise to be your strength when you are weak, and to be your champion when you are strong. I promise to enjoy life's little moments with you. I promise to encourage and support your dreams and aspirations, and to be kind, patient, and loving. But most of all, I promise to put you first and to love you with every fiber of my being.
Your turn, Adam.
Matt, I prayed for you before I met you. And the first time I saw your profile, I got on my knees and I prayed again. You stood no chance, honey. The first time you prayed for me, I felt that even God said amen, and that sealed the deal. You're everything I ever wanted. I love your strength of character and compassionate heart. You see me fully, and you love me with all my flaws and all my weirdness. You make me feel safe, you make me laugh, and sometimes wonder what's going on in your hair.
True.
I promise to support you in all you do, in your aspirations and hobbies. I'll probably start by listening to a complete Aphex Twin album. I'm not going to hang a painting on the wall anytime soon. Probably watch the entire Office series with you. I do promise to sit in the shade with a cold drink and some pickle juice when you go for your 100-mile bike ride in the middle of a Texas summer. I'm not going with you, honey. Not happening. I promise to wake up every day and choose to give 100% of me. I promise to vocalize my needs since I know you're still working on reading my mind. Hurry up. I promise to make Jesus the foundation of our relationship and our family. I'm far from perfect, but you love me for who I am. I promise to love you faithfully.
Do we have a token of the vow? Matt, take the ring. Thank you. Put it on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Abby, take the ring. Put it on his finger, and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for this celebration. Thank you for this covenant that is being established. I pray, Lord, that you would bless this marriage. I pray, Lord, that Matt and Abby would be kind to each other. I pray that they would grow closer to you, and that in doing so, they would grow closer to each other. I pray, Lord, for everyone that's in this room. I pray that everyone in this room would commit themselves to helping this marriage work. I pray that when Matt and Abby need help, help will be found. I pray that when they need comfort, comfort will be found. I pray, Lord, that family, friends would bind together to ensure that Matt and Abby continue to bring glory to you by glorifying you in their relationship. Lord, I pray that you would bless this evening, keep us safe. I pray, Lord, that you'd help Matt and Abby as they leave next week on this exciting trip. I pray, Lord, for the families as they return back to their homes. I pray, Lord, that they would be kept safe. And we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So, I pronounce you man and wife. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Matt Schaller. You may kiss the bride.
Now we begin our life today. now walk and dance. Hallelujah. I'm going to give you dancing lessons for free tonight. If you want to dance, please feel free to join us on the dance floor. Then we rock it this place out tonight. Now we have a Hino Man.
City.
You know that that dance was good. I want you to give them all the unity that you can give them. Because this is not a competition. They are going to compliment each other. They are going to compete each other. You've got to give them a yay. Yes. All right, before we start, we're going to take an open prayer. So please, if you don't mind, you can rise on your feet. You can rise on your feet as we do a quick open prayer. Father, we thank you. And in this moment, I know that in your heart you wish this couple well. So I just want you to say a word of blessing and give them your good wishes and your good prayers in just 1 minute. And Father, we thank you for this beautiful couple. We thank you for what you are doing today. Thank you for everyone who has come here to share in their joy and to share in their love. We thank you, O God, that these ones have put their faith in you. We thank you, O God, that just as marriage is representative of you, of Christ and his church, that this marriage will continue to represent you in every ramification. We thank you, O God, that as they have put their trust and their faith in what you have done on the cross, that they will continue to experience your help, your strength, in everything that they do. We pray, O God, that your spirit will be upon us to celebrate, to fill our hearts with your love, with your joy, and that we'll experience your life even more after today. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, put your hands together for God. Put your hands together for Jesus. Thank you.
Most of this, right? Let's go. So I go to my wife, who was here, Marcy, who was around for most of it, right? And she just to come see the most rinky-dink shit show that, you know, that's great. I mean, that's how we knew him. Like, it's like, hey, master. It's like, what? That was an angel tree. So, that's one thing that I was done for. The other thing was, he would fall asleep in a lot of weird places. Actually, the first night I met him, he fell asleep on top of a refrigerator.
Okay, and to all I won't bore you with all the details, but I think I left my ID in the car here. You got it, you brought it to my cubicle. And the rest they say is history, but in my mind, it is an eternity later, right? Okay. Abby, I just want to say you're such a sweetheart. Confident, naughty, witty. You have a comeback for everything, and I love it. I love it. You're wonderful, and anyone who knows you knows what I'm talking about, right? Yes. Your sense for life, your determination, your passion, you know, that go-getter attitude, all of that just scratches the surface of who you are, and I'm sure that's one of the reasons why Matt is just so taken by you, right? Exactly. Abby, you are family to me, and automatically that transfers to you, Matt. Now you're family to me, too. So Matt, I heard about you early on, like right at the beginning when all this started. And just so you know, I was rooting for you from day one. Like, I was right there. And for your future kids, that's how I met your mother and father. Okay? Anyways, I'll wing it from here on. I really just wish you guys the best from here on. You know, just keep God at the center of everything. And if we can all raise our glasses, we're going to toast to the lovely couple. To health, to happiness, to joy unspeakable, to many little ones, or is that three? Mini Abby's and Mini Matt's, there we go. To excellent health, to Abby and Matt.
Yes. Glasses, to life, to joy, to peace, to many good times. So he's the one that has taken the bold step. I'm going to spell his name. Yes, because it really happened. I'm going to spell his name as he drove the bouquet. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to do this together? If you're ready, give me a
front enough for me. corner, corner. Waka, waka, when you enter, I'm a licha. Baby, corner, corner. Will you give me sugar? Wala, wala. Macho, Mona Lisa. 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 Girl, I'll be foolish if I don't let you indulge me. Your lips like poison. I'll take my chance with you. Macho Mona Lisa, Macho Mona Lisa, Macho Mona Lisa.